Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the topic that is drug distribution or distribution of drug. So first one, that is, what is the drug distribution or definition of drug distribution? So distribution which involves the reversible transfer of drug between the compartments, between the blood and the extravascular fluid or tissue in the body. So that is called the drug distribution. So after the absorption process, it means after the drug reach to the systemic circulation, then after go for the drug distribution from blood to the extracellular or extravascular fluid tissue of the body. Which are the steps involved in the drug distribution? So two steps are there. First one, that is permission of free drug through the capillary wall and enter into the extracellular fluid. Second step, the permeation of drug from extracellular fluid to intracellular fluid through the membrane of that tissue, cell or cell membrane. So here the rate limiting step is the rate of perfusion through the ECF and the membrane permeability of the drug. Now the topic is the factor affecting drug distribution. So here the some factors that affecting the drug distributions. Tissue permeability of drug, so that depend on their physicochemical profile or properties of drug and physiological barriers to the diffusion of drug. Second, the organ or tissue size and the perfusion rate. Third one, that is binding of drug to the tissue component, means binding of drug to the blood component and extracellular component and other miscellaneous factors there. So for the distribution of drug, so similar like absorptions, the properties of the drug required, that is unionized in nature, lipid soluble, low molecular weight, and the mechanism for the distribution also similar like passive or diffusion process are there. Protein bounded drug not goes for the distribution. One by one we have to see the factors affecting drug distribution. The first one, that is tissue permeability of drug. In that, first part is physicochemical properties of drug. In that, they depend on molecular size, dissociation constant, and the lipid solubility or lipophilic nature, it means partition coefficient. So molecular size less than 500 or 600 Dalton easily cross the capillary or simple cell membrane. That water soluble molecules and ions of size less than 50 Dalton pass the cell membrane, capillary membrane or aqueous filled channel. Large molecule size is there, so it is restricted by that cell membrane, so that require the specialized transport system like carrier transport, carrier mediated transport system like active transport. Second, the degree of ionization or dissociation constant, pK. So the pH at which the half of the drug is in unionized form and half of the drug is ionized form, that is called the pKa or dissociation constant, ionization constant. Most of the drugs are weak acid in weak base nature, and their degree of ionization, that is depend on the pKa value, that based on the pH. So the pH of blood and extracellular fluid, okay, 7.4 around pH, the constant their pH value is there. So they play a role on the degree of ionization. It means drug is ionized form or unionized form. Unionized form easily diffuse across the cell membrane. Then partition coefficient, log P value, lipophilic natures. So lipoidal drug penetrate easily or diffuse easily through the cell membrane. If polar or hydrophilic drug are less likely to cross the cell membrane, non-polar, hydrophobic and lipophilic nature of the drug are more likely to cross the cell membrane. So unionized drug and lipophilic can easily cross the cell membrane. So that time the high partition coefficient we have to require, so that easily cross that membrane and go for the distribution. Next one, that is physiological barriers to the diffusion of drug. So here the list of that barriers are there that affect into the distribution part. Simple, capillary endothelial barrier and simple cell membrane, blood wave barrier, blood CSF barrier, blood placental barrier and blood testis barrier. One by one we have to see. The first one, simple capillary endothelial barrier. So it is a generalized simple barriers are there. Capillaries supply the blood to the most inner tissues. All the drug is ionized form or unionized form with molecular size less than 500 or 600 Dalton, easily diffused through the capillary endothelial membrane and reach to the intestinal fluid. Only bounded drugs that not cross that or larger molecules like, other than all the drug that cross that capillary membrane. Simple cell membrane, so in that also it is similar to lipodial barrier in GI tract. Simple cell membrane, lipophilic nature, drug easily crossed by the passive diffusions. Next one, that is blood brain barrier. So highly specialized and less permeable to water soluble drugs. So it is highly restricted barriers are there. Specific drug only cross that barriers. So that brain capillaries consist of specific endothelial cells which are joined one another by continuous tight intercellular junction. So that restrict the passage of drug, they block down the drug to cross that barrier and reach to the brain. So blood-brain barrier is highly lipodial barrier, so it allows only that drugs which having a high partition coefficient or high lipophilic nature, so that diffuse passively. Next one, blood CSF barrier, blood cerebrospinal fluid barrier. So similar like blood wave barrier, but here the difference, the capillary endothelial, that line choroidal plaques have open junction. However, the choroid cells are joined each other by the tight junction. So only here also highly lipid soluble unionized drug can easily cross the cell membrane. Next, blood placental barrier. Okay, the maternal and fetal, they have to separate out by the blood placental barriers. So maternal and fetal blood vessels are separated by number of tissue layers, that is made up of fetal thrombloblast, basement membrane and endothelium. So that is placental barriers. Many drugs having molecular size less than 1000 Dalton and moderately lipid soluble water soluble drug easily cross that placental barrier. So it is not a highly specific or effective like blood wave barrier and blood CSF barrier. Next one, blood testis barrier. So this barrier is located at a Sertoli-Sertoli cell junctions. It is a very tight junctions neighboring Sertoli cell that act as a barrier and they restrict the passage of all the drugs to the spermatocyte and spermatids. So these are the barriers, physiological barriers that affecting the drug distribution. Next factor is organ or tissue size and the perfusion rate. Okay, the perfusion rate is defined as the volume of bloods that flow per unit time, per unit volume of that tissue. So commonly we can say that greater the blood flow, faster the distributions are there. Highly perfused tissue organs such as lung, kidney, liver, heart, brain like that are rapidly equilibrated with the lipid soluble drug because highly perfused organs are there. So blood flow is high to the particular organs. So the concentration amount of drug reached to that particular organs is high and faster as compared to poorly perfused organ. So the extent to which a drug is distributed in a particular tissue or organs that depend upon their size or the volume, tissue volume. So higher the tissue volume or size, the higher amount of drug reach or distributed to that particular tissue or organ. Distribution is permeability related in the following case. So when the drug is ionic, polar or water soluble, so that is based on that permeability based distributions are there, where the highly selective physiologies are there. So barrier restricted the diffusion of drug inside the cell. So that is dependent on permeability based factors. Perfusion rate limited where the distributions are there. So following cases, when the drug is highly lipophilic, so permeability problem is not there. So that is rate limiting step is perfusion rate. If perfusion rate higher, so highly lipophilic drug reach to the distributions. When the membrane is highly permeable, that time also distribution perfusion rate limiters are there. So here in the table, they are given the classify the highly perfused organ, moderately perfused and poorly perfused organ. So in that highly perfused lungs, kidney, brain, heart like that cover into highly perfused where the perfusion rate is high. Moderately perfused muscles, skins are there, poorly perfused organs are there in the fat, bone like that. Next factor is binding of drug to the tissue component. So in that, so binding of drug to the plasma proteins, okay, the proteins which are present in the blood, the plasma proteins are there. So that also alter the distribution part because protein bounded drug does not go for the distribution or metabolism or excretion process. Only free drug, unbound drug go for that process. So binding of drug to the plasma protein is reversible. The extent of order of binding of drug to the various plasma proteins. So these are the plasma proteins which are present in the plasma blood, the albumin, glycoprotein, lipoprotein and globulin. In that, albumin have a major site, four binding sites are there. So large amount of drug bind to the albumin then compared to lipoproteins or globulins. So here the human serum albumin, mostly most of the drug, acidic, basic, hydrophilic, hydrophobic, all class of drugs bind to the albumin. They have a large amount of binding capacity, both endogenous compound and drug bind to the albumin. There are four binding sites are there. And the amount of concentration of albumin also higher as compared to other plasma protein in the blood. Second one, binding of drug to the alpha 1 acid glycoprotein. So in that specific basic drug natures contain like imipramine, lidocaine, like the drug bind to that glycoprotein. Binding of drug to the lipoproteins. So in that case, drug that bind to the lipoprotein does so by dissolving in the lipid core of the protein, and thus its capacity to bind that depend upon its lipid content. So non-competitive type of bindings are there for that drug. Binding of drug to the globulin is alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, beta 2, gamma. So their specifics are there. So alpha 1 globulin, number of steroidal drugs bind to that, cortisone, prednisolone like that. For alpha 2, vitamin ADEK like that, by beta 1 globulin, so bind to the ferrous ion, beta 2 bind to the carotenoid and bind to the antigen for the gamma globulin. So these are the type of drugs that bind to the particular proteins, globulins. Other than plasma proteins, binding of drug to the blood cell also. So major component for the blood cells or blood is RBC, so red blood cells. It comprises of three components, hemoglobin, carbonic anhydrase and their cell membrane. So specific drug bind to the hemoglobin, example phenytoin, phenobarbital, phenothiazine, like their drugs bind to the hemoglobin. So drug like chlorothiazide, acetazolamides that bind to the carbonic anhydrase and into cell membrane, imipramine, chlorpromazines are bind to the RBC cell membrane. So there is the binding of drug to the tissue component. In that, other than plasma blood component, in the tissue parts also there is a specific drug bind to the binding of the tissue. The liver, lung, kidney, skin, eye, hair, so the examples are there for that drug that bind to the tissue binding and that also alter into the drug distribution part. Next one, that is last factor, that is miscellaneous factor. Okay, in that age, so age also affect for the distribution of drug. So you can see that the total body water contain is greater in the infants, both ICF, ECF. Fat content is also higher in infants and elder patients. Skeletal muscles lesser in infants and elder persons. So like that the difference are there, so that also alter the distribution pattern. Organ composition, blood-brain barrier is poorly developed in infants as compared to adults. So that is not highly specific, so that can't restrict as compared to the normal adult person. Cerebral blood flow is high, has greater the penetration of drug to the brain. Plasma protein contain as compared to adults, so low albumin in both the infants and elders, so less protein binding, so higher amount of drug distributed to the infants and elders as compared to adult. Other than age, diet also, so diet high fat content will increase the free fatty acid, so that circulations of that free fatty acid levels affecting the binding of acidic drug such as NSAID drugs to the albumin, so that alter the distribution pattern. Obesity, obese persons are there, so high adipose tissues contain can take up the large fractions of that lipophilic drug. During the pregnancy, the growth of uterus, the placenta and fetus increase the volume available of the distributions of the drug, so that we can see the placental barriers become thinner and all the drugs cross during the pregnancy, so that also altering the distribution pattern. Disease state, during the pathophysiological conditions, during the disease pattern also alter the distribution part, alter the albumin concentration or drug binding protein concentration, alter or reduce the perfusion rate, so alter the distribution part, alteration of tissue pH during the disease, so that pH alter, so the ionization factor affect the degree of ionization, so that also affecting to the distribution part. Next, that is volume of distribution, so that terminology is there, volume of distribution. So it is defined as a hypothetical volume of body fluid into which the drug is distributed. So volume of distributions, also known as apparent volume of distributions, is used to quantify the distribution of drug between plasma and the rest of the body, so after the administration of the dose. So that is explained by the equation, the x is equal to vd into c. So VD is equal to, called as a volume of distribution, is equal to X upon C. So X is the total amount of drug in the body divided by plasma drug concentration. So we can say that apparent volume of distribution is equal to amount of drug in the body divided by plasma drug concentration. So it is expressed in the unit of liter or liter per kg body weight. Here in the table, the volume of distribution of drugs, some examples given by classify based on their low volume of distribution, medium, high and very high. Okay, so in that examples are there, warfarin, ibuprofen, low volume of distributions are there, as compared to chloroquine, very high volume of distributions are there. So from the volume of distribution is high, so we can say that drug distribution throughout the body is also high. What are the application of volume of distribution? So volume of distribution provides the qualitative information of the drug. Amount of drug in the body can be determined by that. We can use VD is equal to X upon C. From that, we can find out the total amount of drug. In case of target, the plasma drug concentration, so we can go for dosage regimen, can be fixed. Dosage regimen means we can adjust the dose size and dose frequency. Loading dose required to achieve the steady state concentration can be estimated by the volume of distribution. Individualization therapy, individual patient, what is the dose required, that we can calculate. If drug-drug interactions are there, so that can be explained. If drug bind with the protein, so protein binding of that, total body clearance, that also we can calculate by the volume of distribution. So these are the points discussing about the drug distribution. Thank you.